start the world.
What does he need to do to beat Americano?
Well, we all know that Americano's a great boxer. You know what I mean? He can box. He can very fast around the ring, and he throws quick punches. So Philip has to cut the ring off, and we got to make sure we move our heads out of sight, and then I'm not going to say anything else because it's a game plan. We got good things that we've been working on, and he's been looking great at sparring.
Now, if Fernando Vargas was sitting on a bus and Conor McGregor took a dolly and threw it on your bus, what would you do?
Pato, you can answer that question.
You would get off and kick his ass. You're not waiting like, scared. Why didn't Khabib go after him?
I don't even know really the whole situation about what happened, but all I know is that I saw him throw something like a, what was it, like a big old...
A dolly. Yeah, and a trash can and a...
And a trash can to a bus. Hey, I'm telling you, it would have been me. It would have been a different thing.
I think you jumped out the window that's broken and you chased him.
You got to, I mean... That's disrespectful. I don't know what happened.
This is what happened. The Russian guy, Khabib, with all his team, confronted one of Conor's friends, an Irish Russian guy. So Conor hopped on a plane and came to confront Khabib.
Yeah, but come on, man. It's a little crazy, man. Like, you know what I mean? Then I just think that, you know, there's a time and a place for all that. You know what I mean? But to get crazy. Sometimes the hood can, you know, you can't take the hood out of you. You know what I mean? Sometimes you can get crazy like that. Because I'm not going to say I've been perfect and, you know, I haven't overreacted in times. And, you know, when you get pissed off, you get pissed off.
Now, Phil Greco, what surprised you about Phil?
You know what? Phil Greco surprised me with his power. He has very stinky power. You think that he doesn't, but, you know, and he has, you know, some good knockout. You know, power, and people wouldn't think that.
Mayweather in MMA, how would he do?
Mayweather in MMA, if they don't get him on the ground, they won't even be able to touch him.
Okay, Mikey Garcia Crawford, what do you think?
I think that Mikey Garcia is a beast. I don't see nobody beating Mikey Garcia.
Lomachenko Lenore.
That's going to be a great fight. You know what I mean? I'd rather not say. I'd rather just, you know, watch it.
Okay, last one. Wilder Joshua.
I'd rather not say either.
By the way, Shane Mosley gave you a lot of compliments this week. I interviewed him. He said you're doing great as a trainer. He likes your work.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that, you know. But it ain't me. It's him. I mean, because me, I asked God to help me to be able to teach what I've learned as a fighter and be able to translate it and transmit it as a trainer. And I've been able to do that, but it's not me, it's the Lord. And that, you know, that's why we have national champions. We have four number ones in one gym. You know, we have one, you know, that's my son, Emiliano Fernando Vargas, El General. Then I got Wesley Diana that we just turned pro. Then we have Alexis Espino that's right now in Bulgaria that just finished winning the Bulgarian tournament and never has another champion has been able to, from Las Vegas, been able to win that, and here in Las Vegas, first time ever. So then I got my son, I'm out of that, you know, he's ranked in the top 10 but he started late, but you know, he's gonna catch up later on. You'll see.
All right, and good luck in England, Philip Greco. Anything to tell Amir Khan?
No, we're ready. I'm here. Me and Amir have always been cordial. He's a great fighter. I respect him, and I always have respect for another fighter. So, this is a business we're in, and so he knows that that's what it is. You know, may the best man win.
Fernando Vargas, please report to the Publicist about 40.